Now is 5:37. Within the first 2 days of drone registration, the FAA registered 45,000 copters, and that was before the Christmas rush.
That's huge. Well, now hundreds of thousands of people own drones and need to follow the regulations. Jenna Jane joins us now with one app that can help. Jenna, good morning.
Good morning, Jordan and Cerise. If you have one of those copters, it's likely one of the tiny ones and you're only going to fly it indoors. If that's the case, probably not going to have anything to worry about. But if you have one of those bigger ones and you're trying to make sense of all the regulations, just wait, there is going to be a new app out by the FAA. It's called B4U Fly. That's going to have a bunch of interactive maps and information to help guide you through those regulations, including finding safe locations on where to fly, any restrictions on an airspace that you're in, and also requirements that you have to meet before you fly in a space. But if you need something right now, you can try this app. It's called Hover. It works in much the same way. Open the app and it will let you know the weather and the direction that the wind is blowing. You can also set up your GPS coordinates on it, and it will let you know if you're in a no-fly zone. Now, here at WOWT, we're within 5 miles of the airport, so I wouldn't be able to legally fly a drone. I would have to move outside of that orange circle. Now, the app also lets you log a flight, keep track of news in the drone industry by following a variety of blogs. It has a lot of different interesting aspects to it, guys, and really it just sounds like this is one of the new ways that they're trying to kind of figure out all of these regulations and get information out to the public.
Yeah, wow. Easy way to see what you're supposed to do and what you're not allowed to do.
Right.
I'm pretty sure there's an app for everything now.
There is.
All right, Jenna Jane reporting this morning. Jenna, thank you. 5:30.